Over the years, we've seen what a hurricane can do to our coastline, eroding our beaches and causing roads and homes to crumble. Well, new at 4 o'clock, there is a new push to build a natural line of defense against future storms to stop this from happening again. West Chu's Volusia County reporter Pamela Combs shows us the idea of a living seawall.
After Hurricanes Ian and Nicole wrecked the coast, Daytona Beach researchers began looking into ways to make these concrete seawalls more resilient during storms.
So seawalls that we have right now are just man-made structures that provide really good resistance to these natural forces such as wind and wave action, but they lack the resilience that you see in natural coastal dunes.
Researchers at Embry-Riddle and Bethune-Cookman University teamed up to find a solution. They believe a living seawall is the answer. Instead of it being just a concrete wall like we have now, they'll have a concrete element that'll then be covered in sand resembling a sand dune.
So while the structural component would prevent large-scale impact on the residential side, we also hope that the green components would prevent erosion of the beach and also help in accumulation of sand dunes.
The team held two community meetings this month to get feedback and complete a final design. Researchers tell us they were awarded a six-month planning grant to get some blueprints together. Once complete, early next year, they'll apply for a $1 million implementation grant.
So it's likely to start if we get it sometime in the fall of 2025. And so in that time period, we'll have the ability to implement our hybrid design and hopefully in a couple of different locations throughout Volusia County.
Once complete, the seawalls will look something like those up in Flagler County. Residents are excited about this possibility. It will not only be good for the wildlife, but also help protect homes and businesses near the beach. Reporting in Volusia County, Pamela Combe, West 2 News.
Now that they've met with the community, researchers will start to meet with community partners and city leaders to figure out permitting and best spots to implement this living seawall.